So today we will discuss about our next king in Vishnu Pundits, Madhav Varma II. Please do remember, guys. He was the most powerful king in Vishnu Pundits. His time period was from 456 to 503 AD. And this Madhav Varma II defeated Vakatakas king Prithvi Sena, who was ruling Vakataka dynasty. And after that, he was forced to give his daughter Vakataka Mahadevi to Madhav Varma's two son Vikramendra Varma one. So the king Prithvisena, who got defeated in the hands of Madhav Varma II, later he was forced to give his daughter Vakataka Mahadevi to Madhav Varma II's son Vikramendra Varma one in exchange of matrimonial alliance to protect his kingdom. So in this way, Madhav Varma II extended his empire into Maharashtra. And how we know this thing? From Kanpur copper plate inscription, we came to know this information. Please remember it, guys. In the same way, Madhav Varma II also defeated Ananda Gotrajas, Salankayas and Pallavas. But here, Ananda Gotrajas, the king, Samiksambuddha Padapatmaradaka. In that same way, you can observe, we have discussed in this our earlier classes, guys. Please do observe here. Madhav Varma II killed Samyaksambuddha Padapadmaradaka. Madhav Varma II also killed Vijayaskanda Varma of Salankaya dynasty, Prithvisena of Kataka dynasty. In the same way, he also killed Vasishtas of Devarashtram, today's Yelamachli in Vishakhapatnam. So these all kings were defeated by Madhav Varma II. So after the defeat of Ananda Gotrajas and Salankayas, Madhav Varma II concentrated on Pallavas. These Pallavas were ruling South Andhra Pradesh. So to defeat Pallavas, Madhav Varma II sent his elder son Deva Varma to conquest on Pallavas. To defeat conquest on Pallavas. But unfortunately, Deva Varma died in this battle. So now Deva Varma, son Madhav Varma III, who was the grandson of Madha Parma II, was became a viceroy military general of Madha Parma II. And this Madha Parma III was the son of Deva Varma, who was the son of Madha Parma II. It means Madha Parma II's grandson was Madha Parma III. So this Madha Parma III took revenge on Pallavas. So in this way, Madha Parma II also fought against Pallavas. Why they are fighting against Pallavas? Because Pallavas were supported by their support Salankayas internally. So here the concept is Shatrukshatru, Shatruku Mitrudu, Mitruku Shatrudu. Right, this is the concept. So Pallavas, who were supporting Salankayas, and they were also against Vishnukundins. So these Vishnukundins who were supporting Madha Parma II. So there is a triangle battle which I explained in our previous classes. Right? So in this way, Deva Parma died in this battle, and Madha Parma III became the king. Madha Parma III became a viceroy or a military general of Madha Parma II. This Madha Parma III was defeating Pallavas. So this thing is going on. And unfortunately, after the death of Madha Parma II, who became the king? Vikramendra Varma I. Please to remember, who is this Vikramendra Varma I? Who married Vakataka Mahadevi, right? But this Madha Parma III wanted to become the king. So he fighted against Vikramendra Varma I. And in this way, there is a conflict, started a conflict between Madha Parma III and Vikramendra Varma I. So as you know, Vikramendra Varma III later killed by Vikramendra Varma I. Next, this Madha Parma II also defeated Pitapuram kings. We call it as today's Kakinada. In the same way, he also defeated Deva Rastram kings. Nothing but Yellamanchili kings in Vishakhapatnam. So now, complete North Andhra Pradesh, as well as East Andhra Pradesh, West Andhra Pradesh, complete Telangana, and south of Maharashtra was now under Madha Parma II. So to annex all these kingdoms, Madha Parma II to annex all these kingdoms like Salankayas, Pallavas, in the same way Ananda Govatraja kingdom, next Pitapuram kingdom, Devarashtram. So to annex Salankayas, Pallavas, Ananda Govatrajas, Pitapuram kings, Devarashtram kings, and Vakataka dynasty kings, he did 11 Ashwamedha Yagas. Please remember, guys, Madha Parma II, to annex all these kingdoms, he conducted 11 Ashwamedha yagas. In the same way, he also conducted 16 Vajapeya yagas, one Hiranya Garbha yaga, one Hiranya Garbha yaga. In the same way, one Naramedha yaga and other 1000 of rituals. So to annex these kingdoms, he conducted 11 Ashwamedha yagas, 16 Vajapeya yagas, 1 Hiranyagarbha yaga, 1 Naramedha yaga and other 1000 of rituals. Please do remember, this is very, very important bit. Please do remember, guys. In Andhra, which king performed maximum number of yagas? The answer is Madhav Varma 2. And he also constructed Ramalingeshwara temples. Madhav Varma 2 also constructed, please to remember guys, Ramalingeshwara temples to commemorate victories over Salankayas, Anandagotrajas, Pallavas, Devarashtram, Vakataka dynasty. Please do remember guys, these all kingdoms were defeated by Madhava Varma too. So he constructed Ramalingeshwara temples at that site. So the famous places where he constructed his Ramalingeshwara temples are important for us. You all are well aware of Indrapala Nagaram area. In this Indrapala Nagaram area, he constructed Ramalingeshwara temple. Amreshwara temple, Mallikarjuna temple, Rameshwaram temple, at which place? Today's Tummalagudi. In the same thing, in Epuru village, he constructed Ramalingeshwara temple at Kesara Gutta, your beloved near Madhachal district in Telangana. He also conducted Ramalingeshwara temple. Next, at Nalagonda district, Chirugattu, at Nalagonda district. Please to remember, at Nalagonda district, at Chiragottu, he constructed Jadala Ramalingeshwara temple, and the last one at Shadnagar in Telangana, Rangareddy district, he constructed Uttara Raja Ramalingeshwara temple. And in the same way, we don't know the place, exact place, but he also constructed Dantamukha Swami temple, which is in Telangana. So these all temples were constructed by Madhavarma to commemorate the victory over his neighborhood kingdoms. Please do remember, guys. You are well aware of Undavalli caves. Madhav Varma one constructed. Please remember, guys. Madhav Varma one constructed Undavalli caves in Guntur. In the same way, this Madhav Varma II constructed, inscribed Purna Kumbha in Undavalli caves. Please do remember, guys. So Madhav Varma I constructed Undavalli caves, right? And this Madhav Varma II inscribed Purna Kumbha on Undavalli caves. Please to remember it, guys. He also inscribed, Madhav Varma II also inscribed couple of inscriptions at Ipuru. Ipuru and Kanpur inscription. You already studied about a Kanpur inscription. And the most important part regarding the Madhav Varmas, what are his titles? Please do remember, guys. According to Palamuru inscription, his title was Trivanagara Bhuvana Sundari. Please do remember, guys. Trivanagara Bhuvana Sundari was his title. In the same way, his other titles were also Trimudradipati, Janashraya, Paramesti. Parma Brahmana and Devadi Deva. These were the titles of Madhava Varma. So please do once again go through all these notes once again about this Madhava Varma too, which is very, very, very important one, because here you can find various number of battles, titles, rituals, temples, inscriptions. So this is very, very important point. So in our next session, we will discuss about the later Vishnu Kundins. Thank you.